in the chat. If you are just getting here, go ahead and like this video and subscribe if you haven't already. Do you know almost 76% of the people who watch my videos aren't even subscribed to my channel? Why is that? Y'all better subscribe. Caller 8194, hello.
Hey, how you doing tonight?
I'm good. How are you?
Good, enjoying the discussion, and I love tonight's show. Oh my God.
It was great, wasn't it?
It was so juicy, and I can't wait for next episode. Like, sometimes I wish I could just save them on my DVR and then just binge out because I get excited.
Well, you know, the full episode is always available over on my website, straightfromtheA.com, and you can go watch any of them. I mean, like, when I say from season 2 all the way up to now, they're all on my site.
No, I did not know that, and I will do that. No, I had no idea, actually. That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
But, okay, so I was just calling because I'm hearing all this beautiful comments about Kenya. I just want to remind people, everyone knows she's pretty, and even Lucifer was the prettiest angel in heaven, but he still had to be cast away. Just because you're beautiful on the outside, that don't really mean anything. Kenya is wicked. And I agree with the other caller. Hurt people hurt people. Kenya's beauty does not have anything to do with how she treats people. And I'm on this group on Facebook about, like, the Atlanta Housewives, and a lot of the twirl people love to say that Mark is abusive. I don't see the abuse.
I don't see the abuse either.
I don't know what happens behind camera, but disagreeing with someone is not abusive.
Right. I agree.
And a lot of people will go as far, like old fashioned people will go as far as, if a woman don't take or support their man, then they're not a good wife. Meaning, if she was knowledgeable that Mark didn't want to be on TV and she pressured him to be on television, I could understand his animosity.
True.
I'm not sure if y'all heard where he said asshole at the beginning of the show. So she has asshole tendencies, especially if you're forcing your husband to do something he doesn't want to do. And I'm not a married woman, but one thing I do want to say is that how it's kind of gross how Kenya talks about, like, she's a wife and trying to say that what the other girl, she's just a fiance. Mm. The whole situation scares me for when I am mature enough to get married, to be married, because how it almost seems like you have to be so selfless that you don't even have your own identity anymore. And then something else Kenya said, that she's scared to be alone. Like, I never want to be in a part of my life where I'm scared to be alone, that I'll just be rushed in to get married.
And
I don't know if it's society.
And that's the point. I think Kenya kind of romanticizes marriage, you know, and that's what she gives me. Like, she keeps talking about what a marriage is supposed to be. Well, clearly your marriage is not that. Like, you cannot make a marriage be that if it's not built on that foundation. And so for her to go into a marriage thinking that it's just going to be, you know, flowers and fairy tales just because that's what she thinks a marriage is, I think is telling in itself as far as where her mentality is.
Yes, it is. I got a question for you.
Yes.
Do you feel like the show is pressuring these women to be wives? Because even Cynthia, I feel like she's moving very quickly. Like, or is it like something when someone gets in their 30s that women outside the show just feel pressured to get married? Like, I really, what is your opinions on that? Do you think the show, or she's just being a woman, wants to be married?
Her, I don't think the show necessarily pressures it, but I think, you know, as far as, you know, the show is called Housewives. So, of course, you know, us as fans, like, I even have an interview where I was talking to Cynthia, and at the time she was married to Peter, and during that season, I think Claudia Jordan was on there, Kenya was on there, and I was like, it's more unmarried housewives on this show than it is married housewives. And so Kenya, you know, Cynthia was like politicking for the unmarried housewives. She was like, but there's things in their lives, you know, they're dating, blah blah blah. So I think that, you know, yes, relationship is an important aspect to this show, so I think that's why they kind of force it. But like Cynthia and Mike Hill, I'm not, you know, like, I don't think, personally, I don't think there's any chemistry. They was giving me fake teas from the beginning when, you know, they were on Steve Harvey. And before they actually met on Steve Harvey, she was on his podcast with Claudia Jordan months before that. So it's like, to me, it's too much scheming and, you know, it's like. And
what you mean he's like, he was on a podcast with Claudia, you mean like flirtatious or they were just working?
Well, she was a guest on the Unstable podcast. The actual post is on Straight From The A, and I put the link in the comments after this. But, yeah, she was a guest on that podcast before, and I actually did a post that said Cynthia met Mike Hill before they met on Steve Harvey. So when you see stuff like that, it's like, it's too much tomfoolery. And the same thing with Kenya. All these years with the Matt situation, with the Walter situation, with the African prince that was invisible, with the man on the Millionaire Matchmaker who she was claiming was in her bed, but it was a mannequin head. Like, it's just, I have a PhD in RHOA, so I keep up with all this stuff. So, you know, when you see them pulling these stunts and stuff, it's like, what is really the truth? And the reason why I ride so hard for people like NeNe is because we know her relationship ain't fake. At least we know that. You know what I'm saying?
I agree. Well, I have a message to the people that you deal with as a young 25-year-old new in this world. Not new in this world, but new in, like, I'm a slow learner when it comes to relationships. Mm-hmm. They really give the vibe that you have to be married to be successful or as a social norm in this world. And it kind of confuses me, a single woman, because I feel liberated, not feeling the pressure, but maybe because I'm young. But when I see, and I use the term role models loosely, but when I see beautiful black women on television that are successful, it kind of makes me feel like maybe I'm missing something because I don't have a man.
You 25. Let me tell you this. When I was 25, yeah. I was married. I got married when I was 22. I was married from 22 to 32. I was married for 10 years. And I wish that I was not. I feel like that was 10 years of my life. I could have had a whole 10-year jump start. I've been divorced for 10 years. So, you know, the years that I've been divorced, I became my own boss. I started my own website. I bought multiple properties. I travel. I do what I want to do. I tell anybody, marriage is not the end all be all. Of course, we all want a companion. We all want love in our life. But don't think that if you don't have a man, if you don't have a marriage, that your life is incomplete, because you can do so much without, you know what I'm saying? So, well, yeah, I just don't, yeah. Yes. If I was 25 right now, I could go back and tell my younger self something, it would be, girl, don't get married in your 20s.
No, I appreciate that. And now I'm going to use you as a role model. I didn't know if all your great success and you're fabulous and you're doing your damn thing. And I don't know your love relationship, but I'm assuming that you're happy single. That's my whole thing. They make me feel bad for being single, and hearing your story, that makes me feel great.
Yay. Good.
I just felt like I see Sun Tanya. You're a fiance. Like, you're so cold-hearted.
But think about it this way. Tanya is a fiance, and Tanya lives with her man. Tanya be with her man on the daily. Kenya is married and her man is across country. Like, at the end of the day, like, who's winning? I feel like Tanya is, whether she's married or not. Exactly. She has a happy, healthy relationship that she's happy with. Whether, you know, and Kenya did all of this rush to have a baby, rush to have this happy situation, and it's not, and from all appearances, like, I don't know, you know, off camera what it is, but from all appearances on camera, it's not a happy situation. She's a single mother at this point.
Right. Oh, God. And that's sad. Yeah. But you guys have a great night, have a great week, and I will visit your website.
Thank
for
you.
For all the good stuff you just said.
Thank you. I appreciate your call. All right.
Bye-bye.
Good night.